So before we proceed with the composite conductor, last week we already learned how to calculate resistance and inductance of the transmission lines. Inductance for the solid conductor, okay? That's for solid conductor. Okay, so now we will see how to calculate the inductance of the composite conductor. This is a composite conductor. Actually, in the real life, the conductor is not solid conductor. The conductor is a composite. The composite means the conductor, we have multiple subconductors. Let's say this is X conductor. We have multiple subconductor, which name as A, B, C, D, and until N. Okay. So, and then we have another conductor, we name it SY. We have multiple subconductors inside that conductor, named as A prime, B prime, C prime, D prime, and M prime. So we have this composite conductor. We have X and Y conductor, which is this X conductor. Let's say this phase A, this phase B, and we have another phase C. Phase A, we have multiple subconductors inside that conductor. Sometimes we call it a stranded conductor, composite conductors, and there's several names. Actually, this is composite conductor, which is they have multiple subconductors. So there is a calculation how to calculate the geometric mean distance (GMD) and GMR for these composite conductors. This is the derivation, so I skip this one. We go straight to how to calculate GMD. Geometric mean distance for the composite conductors. You see, last time for the GMD, last week we learned how to calculate GMD, right? GMD. Let's say for the single phase line, GMD is geometric mean distance between these two phases. Okay, this GMD between these two phases, because we only have one distance D over here. Okay, distance between these 2D actually equal to D. If we have three phase system, GMD for three phase symmetrical arrangement, this one D, yeah? Symmetrical arrangement. This GMD actually also equal to D because we have three same distance. So GMD for three phase symmetrical equal to cube root of D times D times D, actually equal to D. This is what we have learned like in the previous chapter. But for this type of conductor, composite conductor, we have multiple subconductors, you see. So what is the D? This is which have multiple subconductors inside this conductor X. Same goes to the conductor Y. We have multiple subconductors inside the conductor Y. So D, actually for the three single phase, this is D. Okay. For three phase also, this is D. But now we have multiple subconductors. How to calculate D? D actually, GMD, geometric mean distance between this two cable X and Y is given by the root of this N times N. Okay. M times N, root of M times N. This D, A to A prime, A to B prime, the combination of this distance, the subconductors in X to the subconductors in Y. This combination, so D, A prime, D, A, B prime, so on until D ends M prime. So can you hear me, anyone? So you have to talk to me now because I cannot see the screen all the time. Anyone? Okay, thank you.
Yes, sir. Okay,
all right. So because some of your friends still to join this class, so I have to entertain them first. Okay, so we just accept the your friend first, okay? So anyone to ask anything before we start further, go further on the competition line? So can you hear my voice?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So now, this is composite conductors. So, GMD for composite conductor is the combinations of distance between the subconductors in X to the subconductors in Y. We have A to A prime, right? So, A to A prime, A to B prime, and then A to C prime, A to B prime, A to C prime, until N to M prime. And this is a combination of GMD for composite conductors. So how about GMR? GMR for composite conductors is equal to the root of N square. Let's say GMR for conductor X. So we call GMR X for conductor X. GMR for the solid conductor, solid, eh? Last time we learned solid conductor, GMR. R equal to D, S equal to R prime equal to R exponent minus 0.25. If for solid conductor, please remember this one. You may and not find somewhere in your notebook. Okay. GMR for solids is given by this equation. But now we are talking about the composite conductors. That means in one conductor, we have multiple subconductors. We have A, B, C, D, and N. And this is how we calculate the GMR. We cannot use this equation anymore. This equation only for solid. Now we use this equation. Okay. So GMR for the composite conductors is given by this equation. The root of N, N is the this N, number of subconductors. Eh? Let's say we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have N is equal to 5. Okay. Now our root of 5th, this one, 5. Distance between DA, this one DA, DA to A, DA to B. Actually DAA equal to this AA. This one equal to GMR. For one conductor, this is the value for G and DAA lah. So DAB, DAC until DNN. Okay. So that's why for the GMR, this GMR actually equal to, let's say we have five subconductors, the root of five. Of 50, okay. So D, this one D S times another distance. Let's say AB, AAC, NN until NN. So D and N. So DAA, DAB, AA, right? What is DAA? Actually, this is the self GMR or GMR for solid conductor, for one conductor. So solid conductor, GMR is given by D, sometimes we call as DS, some books use R prime equal to R exponent minus 0.025. Okay, 0.25. This is DAA. Now this DAA value, okay, this one. This is given by this same as what we have calculated last week. This R X prime actually R exponent minus 0.25. Okay. This is the GMR for solid conductor. One conductor. Okay. By using this number, we can calculate GMR for conductor with multiple subconductors. Okay. So we will see how to calculate this one. Let's say we have this type of arrangement. This is the composite conductor. We have one conductor. which have triple subconductors like this. We have triple, right? 1, 2, 3. This one radius R. Okay. So determine the geometric mean radius GMR of a conductor in terms of radius. How to calculate the GMR for this three example GMR? We know that GMR for this subconductors and this conductor A, B, C is given by this equation. N square. Sorry, this one N square. So this one also N square. So N square, this distance. So what is the element inside this one? How to know the elements? So we have distance between, let's say we name it as A, B, C. So between, distance between this A and B is DAB. DAB equal to DBC equal to A to B. A to B is 2R. Okay. DBC also 2R, right? Distance between this to this, 2R. So DAC equal to A to C equal to 1R radius plus another radius, 2 radius, another radius, 3 radius, another radius, 4 radius is 4R. Okay, we have this distance and this distance. So what, how to calculate this GMR? Can you try first? Because I want to add your friend first. So the first case, A. We have three conductor, subconductors. Let's be arranged straight line like this. So this, let's say A, this B, this A, B, C. So because we know this radius R, this one also radius R, and this one same, radius R, and so on. So between D between A to B equal to D, B to C. Okay, same goes to D, B, A equal to D, C, B. Okay, distance between this one, A to B, B to A is equal, right? So B to C and C to B also equal. So equal to 2R. Now we have another distance between A to C and C to A. Distance between A to C. A to C equal to 4R. D C to A equal to 4R. Where? The 4R is coming from. 4R is coming from this. This is R, radius. R, radius R, plus radius R, 2R. This one, another 2R. So we have 4R. Okay? 4R. So, to calculate GMR, GMR for this conductor A, let's say, equal to the roots of N. N is number of subconductors. We have N1, 2, and 3. So N is 3. 3 square. And then the element inside this one is D, A, B, D, B, C, D, B, A, D, C, B, D, AC, DCA, and then we have D, actually it start from DAA, DAA, and then DAB. I forgot to put this one, DAA, DAB, DBC, DBA, DBB, we have another D, DBB, here, DBA, DBB, somewhere here, okay, so DBB, DCB, DC, DAC, DCA, DCC. We have another one over here, DCC. Okay. So we have 1, 2, 1 distance, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We should have 9 distance, 9D inside this one. Why 9? Because we want to find the the roots of ninth. So ninth. So the element also should have number nine, number of nine elements. So DAB, DBC, DCA, this one all two R. So we can put replace this one by 2R, 1, 2, 3, 4, power of 4. We have DAA, DBB, DCC, actually this one, DS, R, exponent 0.25, 1, 2, 3, power of 3. We have DAC, DCA, 4R, the power of 2. Why 2? Because we have 2 elements over here. Okay. So now it's become like this. Okay. So you can simplify this by 9. R, this R, the power of 4 times R power of 3 times R power of 2. We have R power of 9. Okay. And then you calculate these elements. 2 power of 4 times exponents minus 0.25 power of 3 times 4 power of 2. You will get this number. Yeah. So try to calculate this one. Can you get this value? 1.01.704R. So you should get this number. So anyone already calculate? Okay, now you get the same answer. Okay, that's for case number one. Then we go to the another examples. Sorry. This one A, you get the same number. For B, B this arrangement. Actually, you can do the same lah. This is still 3 subconductors. Okay. This radius R. So between A, B and C, so all 2R. So let's say we have the subconductors. Okay. All these distances between A, B and C. So D A B equal to D B C equal to D C A and vice versa. Okay, we have D B A D C B D A C. Same as 2R. All 2R. And then what else? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 distances. So GMR for this case, the roots of n squared. N is 3. Our n is 3. Yeah? N is number of subconductors. We have A, 1, 2, 3. N equal to 3. So 3 square actually 9. Because this is n squared. So n square equal to 9. So this 9, put it here. So we have to have 9 element inside this roots, okay? So we have D, start with DAA, then DAB, DAC, DBA, DBB, DBC, until DCA, DCB, DCC. So we have 9 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 elements. So it must mesh with the roots of 9. Okay. So we can simplify this one. It's 9. DAA should be R exponent minus 0.25 for one conductor, right? DS for one conductor. So for solid conductor, this solid conductor 1. This R exponent minus 0.25. Because we have DAA, DBB, and DCC, okay, we have this one. D and this D, and D, okay. DAA actually equal to DBB equal to DCC. This is a GMR for solid conductor, okay. Actually equal to R exponent minus 0.025, okay. Same as DS, same as S prime. Okay, some book use this one, or use R prime. Actually, this the value of R exponent minus 0.25. Okay, because we have 3, A, D, A, A, D, B, B, D, B, C, so we have the power of 3. And then we have D, D, A, B, D, C, A, this one, A, B, C, A, all have the same value, 2R, 2R, power of 6. Okay. So when you solve this equation, you will get the answer. You try first. Can you get this one, 1.46R? You will get 1.46R. So it's in this one. So R must be power of 9, 9 element of R. R power of 6 plus R power of 3, you will get R power of 9. This one is numbers. Okay. So exponent minus 0.25 power of 3 times 2 power of 6. You get 63.0078. Okay. So you should have this value lah. Okay. You should get this value. This one you have to check. So you get the same answer for the second question. Do you get the same answer? Okay.
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you. So that's how we calculate for this one, second one. So the third one, this arrangement, 4. We have a composite conductor, which consists of 4 subconductors, A, B, C, D. So you can do the same. You should get this answer, okay? So we try to solve it, that one. So maybe you can try by yourself. Okay. So this is question number C. We have 4 subconductors with this arrangement. It's not so good, huh? Okay, let's say this A, B, C, D. So D, A, B equal to D, B, C, D, C, A, D, C, D, and vice versa on this one. Okay. So I just use this symbol. That means A, B, B, A is the same. Okay. A, B, and so we have 2 values here. D, A, B and D, B, A. Equal to 2R. Okay, right? So what? How about the distance between A to C, B to D, A to C, and B to D, and vice versa, DAC, DCA, DBD, and DDB. Okay, same. So how to calculate this one? So we have this distance, this one 2R, this one also 2R. So what is the distance with this one? How to calculate this one? Let's say X. Use a theorem of theorem Pythagoras. So how to calculate X? So X actually equal to the square root of 2R square plus another 2R square. This one plus this one, right? 2R square. So equal to, so 4 plus 4, 8. 4R square plus 4R square. So you can simplify this one to get the numbers. Okay. So GMR for this one, same. Because we have 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So N actually equal to 4. So N square equal to 16. So we have the root of 16th element, this one. So we should have 16th D over here. D, 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 D. 6 distances, okay? Inside this roots, okay? The roots of 16 for this 16 elements. Okay, this one start with DAA until D, 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 okay? So we have DAA equal to DBB, DCC, D, D, D equal to exponent minus, R exponent minus 0.25. So we have this element 1, 2, 3, 4. So we should have another 12 element inside this one. DAB, DBC, this one 8 elements. This one 4. Okay, so you have 12 element inside this one. So when we solve this one, we should get this value. Okay. 1.722R. So you should get over here VMR equal to 1.722R. Okay. You try to solve this one. Four subconductors. Let's say this one. So distance between this one, let's say this A, B, C, D. Distance between A to B. What is the distance between these two? This one R. This one another R. So D A B equal to D B C D C A. D C D D A. Still equal to D. This one A B.
Okay.
B A is all the same, right?
Alright.
To listen. First A to B, and then another one B to A. Okay. So this one C to B and D to C, D to C, D, A, B, B, C, C, D, D, A. A, D, this one A, D, A, D. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have 8 times 2R. 8 times, right? Okay, so that's distance between A, B, C, this one. So how about A to C, A to D? We have another distance, right? This one. Okay. So we can find distance between A to B, A to C, A to D, right? Okay, so now we go to A, distance between A to C, actually equal to distance between B to D. Same goes to C to A, and D to B lah. Equal to, and that's what I try to solve this one, actually equal to square root of, this one square root of something, right? Square root of 2R square plus another 2R square. This one anyone lost at this point where this 2R come from, or you can, this, Okay, this point A, this point B, and this point B, this point C. This one, right? A to B is 2R. B to C is another 2R, right? By using Pythagoras theorem, you can find this X, right? A to C. So A to C is given by this equation. This one will get 2.8 for R. Okay. R or R, R squared. R. Okay. And this is distance. So when we want to find the GMR, it's equal to this GMR. 16. Why 16? Because we have 4 subconductors. Our N is equal to 4. So this is N squared. N square equal to 16. Okay, the root of 16. So we start with DAA. This is DAA. Okay, this AA, DAB, DAC, DAD until. So you have to write down all the distances between A, B, A, C, A, D. Start. Until D, D, A, D, D, B, D, D, C, D, D, D. So you should have 16 elements inside this equation. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then another elements until 16th element. Okay. So G, M, R for this example is 16. So we have 4R exponent minus 0.25. this line over there. So we have 4 times R exponent minus 0.2. Why 4 times? Because we have D A A, D B B, D C C, and D E D, which is equal to R prime, which is equal to R exponent minus 0.25. So we have 4 elements. And then we should put another 12 elements. Okay, we should have 16 elements. Now we have 4. So we should put another 12 element, which is 2R. You said we have 8 times, right? 2R we have 8 times, and then we have another element 2.8284. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 elements, this one. DAC, DB, DBD, DCA, and D, D, this one. We have 4 elements. Okay. 2.8284, 4 elements. 2.8284, R, we have 4 elements. If we add together this number, 4 plus 8 plus 4, you will get same number as 16. So we already have 16 elements inside this equation. So you can now calculate the GMR. Okay, so you should get this value, 2R. So now you get this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so settle for this example. We try to solve this example. Word format, example 3.4. Can you see example 3.4? This one. Example 3.4. Can you see example 3.4?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so now, so how to calculate GMR for this conductor? Geometric mean radius for this composite conductor. This is one conductor. Inside this conductor, they have multiple subconductors. They have 7 multiple subconductors. Okay, actually, you can do the same. Okay, this is, we have 7 subconductors. That's mean, yeah, let's say, this one. We have one composite conductor which consists of 7 subconductors. N equal to 7. So N square equal to 49. So we should have 49 elements in our GMR calculation. So this one, 49. But in this case, it's quite simple, it's not simple, but it's quite learnable because the arrangement is same. Let's say we have one cable 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The arrangement or the position of cable 1 until cable 6 is the same. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is the same position. So we have 6 same position for subconductors. The difference is only for cable number 7. Because the distance between this cable to the rest is quite different as compared to cable 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's why we start with this one. So we have to calculate, we have to find, because we have subconductors and conductors. A, let's say this A, B, C, B, E, F, and some F, F and G. This one inside is G. And 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So D, let's say D, 1, 2, equal to D, 2, 3, equal to D, 3, 4, D, and so on. Okay. If we refer to this one, A to 1 to 2 equal to 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6. So we have 1, 2, 3, 6 elements times 2. We have 12 elements over here. Okay. And then we should calculate D1 to 7. 1 to 7, 2 to 7, 3 to 7, 4 to 7, and so on. We have another 2 arc. So that's why in this example, they put B12 equal to B16, 12 equal to D16, equal to D17, equal to 2R. Okay. So all six elements have this value. Six conductors are conductor A and conductor 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 have this combination. So 2R. 1 to 4, distance 1 to 4 is equal to this R plus 2R, 3R plus another R, 4R. So we have 4R. So how many combinations of D1, 4? Actually, this 1 to 4, one combination, 4 to 1, another combination. So we can write like this. So D1 to 4 equal to D4 to 1 equal to D2 to 5, 5 to 2, 3 to 6, 6 to 3. Okay. So go to D2 to 5, D5 to 2, D3 to 6, equal to D6 to 3. So how many elements right now? 1, 2, 3, so 6. And 2, 3, so 6. We have 6 elements over here. Okay. So how to get this 49? 7 elements come from this one. D, A, D, B, B until D. Sorry. It's not A, lah. This one. This 2, 2. This 7, 7. Equal to R exponent minus 0.25. So we have 7 elements. Okay. So by looking at this example, actually they simplify. So this is VMR, the roots of 7 square R prime. R prime is D11, D1, D22, D33, this R prime. So how many R prime in this combination? They have 6. Why 6 over here? 6 because we have 6 same positions of subconductors. Position conductor 1 equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 same position, except 7. 7 conductor, we put it out. So we have B77 over here times 2R. This 2R actually the distance between 7 to other subconductors. 7 to 6, 7 to 1, 7 to 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 6 combination. Okay. 6 combination. Then the rest is have 6 combination also. With this L, this distance. Okay. This A, 1, 2, 2, 3 and so on inside this one. Then by solving this equation, we will get this answer. Okay. So you should try this one first, then we can discuss how either you can get the same answer or not. Actually, you will get the same answer. Okay. By applying the same concept. But we have multiple subconductors and it's quite long way to solve this one. Okay, this combination. You should have inside this one, R times 49, okay. If you look at this, okay, this one, okay. This one, R, 1R, 2R, 3R, 4R, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 times, 6 power of 6. How many R? Then we have another 6R. So you're supposed to cancel out this R. 49. You should have 49 R. Okay. This 2R times 2R, 2R. This one plus this one, you should get this value, 49 R. Okay. So you should get the answer like this. That's for the example in that the textbooks. Okay. Actually, the principle is same. the principle is to calculate GMR for subconductor. Same as the previous example, this one. Same as this one. Concept is same. Okay. Now, then you can calculate for the how many conductor you want. But if they have multiple, many subconductors, it's quite difficult. It's quite complicated. It's just complicated. The method is same. Okay. That's for the composite conductors.